Welcome, welcome, welcome to the Bike Man for You, coming to you live from West Hampton Beach, Long Island, New York. What you're all happy today. We got Tony Joe in the house.
Good morning, everybody. Saturday from Bike Man for You, Bike and Kite. Another day in the Hamptons. Another day for you to see how bicycling, retailing, and customer service is done.
There you have it. Never a dull moment at the biking gripes.
That's the truth.
Never a dull moment.
That is the truth, Bartels.
If you're tuning in, we are bringing you the local bicycle shop to the worldwide web. We got an awesome show today. Today's show is sponsored by the post office in Missouri. To be particular about it and to get exact, it is the Phantom Drive in Hazelwood, Missouri, the Fort Sorting facilities, and also in Columbia. These guys went above and beyond. Quick little story for you about the United States Postal Service. Somebody got a wrong barcode, it's kind of scanned, and it went into this limbo box. The limbo box. And the limbo box can be limbo for quite a while. And if it's somebody's package, it's my butt that's on the line. And if we don't get that package to that person's not going to be able to go on vacation because he doesn't have his tires. Well, he calls us up. He says, you know, I see the tracking number and it says it's going back, but I gave you the right address. So then we get on the phone and we start talking and we start calling. We get down to the bottom line that it was in Missouri. And Shelly Bass and Sean Smith and all of their crew in Missouri, hunted it down, they sniffed it out,
Missouri,
and they
Missouri.
Found it, and they got it to the guy with one day to spare before he was able to go.
Good morning, Joe, how are you?
Good.
So, it's all good. Again, today's broadcast is brought to you by the United States Postal Service, Phantom Drive in Hazelwood, Missouri, and Columbia. Thank you guys for getting the package.
And in nice time job. For his vacation.
In time for his
vacation. So he had a rock on vacation.
So we got Joe in the house. Joe, welcome to the Bike Man for You show today. How are you doing today?
Ocean spray pools.
I'm doing great. Hot tubs and saunas. Going out the door.
Yeah, yeah.
Everyone's happy.
Does it seem like the business or just the economy seems to be turning around? Do you think America is in the right mood right now? Are we going in the right direction?
You know, it's funny that you think you jump over that question, right? One of my delivery crew leaders went into the hospital for an appendix operation 2 weeks ago. So, you know, I'm elected to, you know, be now the new crew leader. So you would think that, you know, hot tubs, $10,000, $12,000, $13,000 are going to waterfront homes, rich and famous, you know, on and on. I'm going to modest homes, regular working guy, you know, maybe no pool, you know, just want a hot tub in the backyard to relax, you know, so.
Mm-hmm.
People feeling good about themselves, spending money, you know, enjoying themselves. So I think we're going to enjoy that.
Okay. That's, and you know, I have that same exact feeling. Thank goodness. It was a long, tough row. I think the economy is turning around. That's a good thing.
All good.
Oh, yeah. Well, did you know that we're streaming live right this second to the world?
Yes.
Have you watched any of our show?
I haven't, but I've certainly heard about it.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Having a lot of fun.
You're the man.
Well, I don't know about that. How may we help you out today, Joe?
Bike covers.
To go over.
Yeah, something. Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Really
a pocket.
Storage.
Tony, Joe, you're going to help that out, right?
Yep.
Yeah. That's an inside item. Come on inside, Joe.
Okay, we're all BMX boy. Yeah. Instead of BMX boy there, come on in, Joe.
All right, so today we got an action-packed show. We got all kinds of stuff. Let me give you a quickie on what's going on. We got the new torque wrench that's out. We're going to be checking that out today. We got a Kenda tube alert. A certain size on Kenda tubes we're having a definite problem with. And I want to definitely bring it to your guys' attention. We're going to have an seat post extraction today. I hope. It could get a little ugly. We might not be able to get this seat out. But we're going to try. We're going to do the old Sawzall technique We also got a derailleur hanger. We're going to be checking out some derailleur hanger and giving you a little scoop on what a derailleur hanger and how badly this guy wiped out his derailleur hanger really bad. And of course, we will find out today if we get to all of this good stuff. You never know. We might get so slammed and busy that we might not get to any of it. But I'm ready. In case we get a little dead time, we're ready to go. We're going to have a safety check. Every bike should go on a... should be safety checking your bike almost every time you pick it up. And it's real simple and easy. You just got to get in that mental mindset so you keep your equipment safe and operating properly. It is a gorgeous day. We got about 80 degrees right now with bright sun. Perfect out. I'm going to leave that mic right there. We'll worry about that. Good morning. How are you?
All right. So quiet today.
A little bit.
What's going on?
Nice to see you. Kala.
Jeez. It's my wife's bicycle.
All right.
Don't tell her I can't remember.
All right. Last name. Last name?
Let's go over here and take a look. Baby G's in the house.
Richmond. Single speed, multiple speed. How long was it brought in? Woman's bike, okay. Some of this stuff is written up, some of it isn't. What's that? Looks like something like that? Alright, that's a plus. Teresa. Yeah, we warranted that bike. Customer like yourself. Which one's you? This guy.
Did I run over something or was it
my head? It blew the bead right off of the tire, so I couldn't, the tire in terms of its wear and tread pattern was fine. With the part that hooks onto the rim is what gave us the problem.
Oh, okay.
That we couldn't reuse that. We just put a tube in it.
Okay.
6518.
Okay. This is brand new. Two pounds.
I know. I'm so so eager.
I know. Pretty exciting, huh? The new seat feels good, and that basket, and the basket lifts off.
I know it does.
Why don't I just take your purse?
No, I got it.
Why don't you just take your wallet? Or just your.
Dun, 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 dun.
No, it's fine. I can do it.
You're not gonna wear your mic.
It's a lotion, very expensive bag. Into a basket? Yeah, what's wrong with that?
Okay. Well, he's picking up, hopefully that's going to get picked. He's going to be picked up with Mike.
That's okay.
Yeah, this just comes up and you're just pushing the button. Yeah.
Baby G!
Don't get it fully. So are you going to make more coffee?
Do you like that coffee? It's vanilla.
Can you get us up on there so we can see who's on, who's checking us out this morning?
Well, are we going to, what's the plan for the rest of the morning? We're going to go to the beach, so whatever you
want. And this is yours.
Thank you so much. And
this and this and this is mine.
Yep. Thank you so much.
Thank you, my dears. I want you guys to have fun.
Thank you.
Thank you.
See, you have the almost just, now Kelly, that's good.
What?
You said it should go down to your forehead, to your eyebrows?
Right, yeah. That low light, she's got it.
Yeah, okay. Any lower, and
we got the same size hip pumps.
That's awesome. All right.
All right, you know the combination to the lock?
Yeah.
Good morning. Morning.
Good morning.
How may we help you out this morning?
It's feeling sluggish today. I think it needs some air.
Sluggish.
Sluggish, unless it's me.
All right. I gotcha.
It's got to get installed, and then we set the wheel circumference and all of the above. It takes us, you know, leave it with us for a little bit.
Okay.
You're looking about $50.
Oh, it's not bad. And you'll close what day?
Wednesday.
Okay. I'll be here, which I'll come in Thursday.
Alrighty. Okay. Have a great day.
Thank you so much.
Enjoy. Young man, how can we help you out this morning?
This got loose all of a sudden.
That got loose all of a sudden.
I don't know.
All right, what else? Fairly new bike, eh?
Yeah.
Got loose all of a sudden. Can I? I think so. Let's get it in the middle. I think I can. You're welcome, my friend.
I don't know if the tires are pumped.
What's that? You don't know if the tires are pumped enough?
Are they good?
All right. What else?
That's it.
Down.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Enjoy, dude. Have fun, all right? Yeah. Ride safe.
Have a great day.
All right, let's see what we got going today. Who is in the house? Now, if you're not from, come on over to our Facebook, our Twitter, our Instagram, and all of that good stuff. We are hitting, oh, you know what? We had a milestone this morning. I got a special message from the little bird, Tweety Bird. We have 600 followers. How sweet is that? Next. trackpad on there. It's just doing track. Here we go. I got you. Got a decent rank. Oh, nice. Nice. So, we got BMX boy in the house. Live now. And that's how it comes up. All right, there we go. There it is. All righty. And there's my little mug in the face. And there's you, BMX. Isn't that exciting? All right. Renesto, Rent-A-Trip, Danny Pantera, Gary, Ken Speed, Jim Frozen, Dwayne, Gary Little. How is everybody doing? Good morning, everyone. That last kid? Oh, yeah.
Good morning, Mark. How are you?
We got to move that down. Back, double back, double back. Oh, boy. Roscoe. My old bell. I can't have Dan. Well, a buck. You barely talk over the top.
You can't move the sauce now. Okay, so which year I'll
stand? Oh. We'll save your pennies. I want a phone. I want a gold watch. It just tells the time or it tells
like
the
Charlie Brown
smart
teacher.
Watch. Is it a smart watch? Is it connected up to your phone?
Oh, was that last night?
That's two.
Oh, I thought it was
too much?
Oh, last night. Oh, cool.
You don't want an Apple Watch?
You don't want an Apple Watch?
But if you got one, I'll be
happy. Oh, yeah? All right. Let's get down to business.
Okay.
So, here's the situation. We got.
Misinterpreted as tonight. Good. Yeah, good night for it.
That has been getting beat on. And been sitting around, and the post is solid in there.
So
now we
so
don't
good,
have a lot to
I know,
go
I gotta
on.
Get, I got to get to the water more. It just feels so.
We've
good.
Got very little bit
so,
sticking
so
out. We've pried out the frame a little bit. We tried to get some special sauce down there. We're gonna cut this off right here to start with. This piece here, I think, is definitely going into here, and we're gonna maybe give this thing a slice down the middle. We'll start to go this way, and we'll try to get some sort of a purchase point in here to start to get some, and then maybe we can get down the edge and try to bite this thing. I don't know yet, to tell you the truth, guys. Okay? We might be buying a new bike. He's got the seat's got to come up. That is the bottom line. So we're going to try the Sawzall at the Sawzall method. We've told the parent, we've told the kids' parents and whatnot, and well, who knows? Here we go. Let's see what happens. Ooh, ah. We're going to need a... So, like I said, we're going to cut that thing off. Let's see what happens, all right? Boys and girls and children of all ages, excuse me, Ellie, I need to get into it. I need an extension cord. Allie, get me an extension cord going in, okay?
Hi. How are you?
Good.
Hey, guys.
Good. How can
I help you? I was wondering if we can rent some bikes.
Be happy to.
We're just going to help you out.
Thanks.
Hi.
Hi.
How many days are you interested in?
Just one.
Okay, so today, one day is our business day, 10 to 5.
Yep.
And the one day rate is $35. You can pay that by MasterCard Visa Discover.
Okay.
Then we require a $20 cash deposit per bike.
Okay.
For you two ladies, right?
Yes.
Cool, let's get some bikes. That's what I'm going to pay for.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Baby G, that was your Friday night. Yeah, how was that? Was the kid a brat or was the kid a good kid? He's a good kid? He behaves himself? You know what I did last night? And I went sailing. I went sailing with Sasquatch.
What a beautiful day today,
Sasquatch, huh? And I went sailing.
Hallelujah.
Sasquatch is, you know.
That's a beautiful weekend.
Yeah, that yeah, it looks great.
It was pretty funny.
It's going
to
be nice.
He had a heck of a time trying to get down. Uh-oh, I got no juice here. What's the story? Over here. Thank you. All right, we got to act next.
Hey, welcome back, Allie, to the right of my desk. Nanette?
Alexander, what can I help you with? You got it. How'd that brake work out, all right? Not really.
so you get numbers.
Dun, 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 dun.
I don't have a number on this bike, Bart. We missed doing one bike.
Yeah, you're going to have to do the Alexandra. One that does have a number. Well, yeah, where she left off on the numbers, that's... like 20-something, I think.
Go inside and see Allie. Okay. Alexander, she's in there? Yes. What is 7-Eleven giveaway today on 7-Eleven? Don't they do something free today? Is it birthday?
Slurpees or something? I don't know.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they do something today.
It's like free school slurpees.
I think it's only select.
7-Eleven, you go down and make a left at the stop sign, and make a left like right there, but I had a big arm, like right there.
All
right. All right, guys, you're set.
Thanks for it. I can see again.
There you go. No problem.
Thank you.
Yeah, I think it is 7-Eleven. Oh, thank heaven for 7-Eleven, one of our proud sponsors, I'll have you know.
Enjoy the weekend, Annette.
You too.
Thank you.
Kiwi's in the house. Robert Russell, Alan C. What's going on, guys? All right, so we have successfully jumped off the top of that. Now we're going to try to make a sweat down the side. I'm going to hope it works. Everybody, if we got any questions, if you need to reach out, if you need to give me a call, please do so. 631-902-0836. And we can answer your tech questions. Is this your banana?
Oh,
yeah. You have a banana in your pocket? Or you just have this? Dun, dun, dun. Wow, that was good.
I'm going to get you a different bike with a basket on it. Good morning.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how you doing?
Amy, how are you this morning?
Hello, Bart. How are you?
I'm doing great.
Glad to hear it.
I'll be right back. You got Sonova in the house. What's happening, Sonova? Yeah? You happy back there? Tired? Tired of what? How may we help you guys out this morning? All right.
How are you doing? I'm so sorry.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Good man.
Okay. What else?
And this is.
So far, you're giving me nothing but, you know, real big problems, baby.
Job.
Big problems. Airing the tires as well, Amy. While we're at it. All right.
Zero.
Good morning, how are you? Be right with you. Picking up a bike?
Yeah.
We'll find out. Mark, could you help me out with a bike here?
And we're at the same side as the CSS car.
Yep.
Follow the rules, gonna read this and sign that. And
when was it brought in and what color is it?
Where do you live? Live in Boston.
Actually, I went to school in Boston. She's from LA. I'm from New York.
Well, oh, cool. Where'd you go to school?
Harvard.
Awesome. Yeah. I'm a Northeastern gal.
Yeah?
Other side of town. I grew up there, but I went to the Northeastern.
Oh, cool.
Mm-hmm. Boy, when I was there, it was like the ghetto.
Oh, close.
You study Harvard.
I got my
good for you. Are you working in the field?
Nope.
All right, that's all right. We all change. So you can pay the 70, the MasterCard Visa Discover. I need $20 cash, the cash deposit per bike.
Yeah.
If you ladies want to just try the bike and see the height, see the right height, height you like, and just when we come back. Thanks.
All right, now it's going to stay. That doesn't look too bad. Yeah, I know. Amy, you're here for a little air as well.
Cool, plus tax.
Out of my hair? You guys would never be in my hair.
The white one. 135.78.
Okay.
Right. You put air in the bike, right?
I did. How may we help you out today, my friend?
The front disc is locked.
The front disc is locked.
Yeah, I think the plate is too close, or... Actually, I think somebody used my bike last weekend when I wasn't here.
Oh.
That's what I think.
Oh, yeah?
Because I rode it 2 weeks ago, and it was perfect.
And now?
But the only thing I can think of is that it's been in a garage that has no air. Could that be a problem?
It has no air right now?
Well, the tires have air. I'm talking about a garage that's very hot, like 110 degrees, probably. Is that a problem?
Nah, it shouldn't be.
Anyway, it seems like the disc is too close.
Okay.
No, we're not.
Thank you again.
You're welcome, man. Thank enjoy. So come on. Try and see.
Okay.
Bart, when you're
free, come in and tell this bike.
Okay. Gotcha.
Hi, how are you? I was here the other day.
Just
run tire and just what? Is that very
yeah,
you don't. But I think the whole.
Well, a couple of things going on here. You know, we're dealing with hydraulic brakes.
Right.
You're not a maintenance guy.
Nope.
We got some issues going on. I am not sure what's going on. I don't know if it's inside of the caliper. I don't know if we got some air in there. I don't know. But it's going to be something that we're going to have to admit, and we're going to check out. When would I promise something like this? Oh, boy. Maybe by the end of the day, but I kind of doubt it. Yeah, you can't ride. You're gonna, go to another shop. Maybe they can bang it out. Obviously, you know, I'm pretty busy here on a Saturday, as you can see. We'll try to get it for you as soon as I possibly can. What's your first name?
Mark.
All right, Mark. Any name and phone number on here for me?
How are you?
Doing well.
We had a blowout here on the front.
Okay.
So this next year.
Okay. The front right. Okay. Got it. Right. So I'm just dealing with the front brake.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
Is there an alignment issue?
I'm not sure what it is. Like I said, I'm not sure if it's a caliper. It might be salt water corrosion inside of the caliper.
The disc has some rust on it.
Yeah. I got to open it up. We're going to check it out. I might need new fluid in there. I'm not sure.
Okay.
You know,
Again, I will let you know. We're gonna be looking somewhere around $50.
Okay.
It might be a quickie, it might be easy. I don't know.
But
until I get it up in the rack, we will be able to tell. But when I get it there, I will let you know. Give me a call late in the day. All right. All right, let go.
Mark, do we have this tire here in stock?
I have something similar to it, not exact. I'm looking at $60. Mark can show it. Mark can know. You see that? Is Mark back there? Mm-hmm. All right, so this bike's been run through the mill a little bit, huh?
This is the third kit on
this bike. The third kit on this bike, so this bike owes you nothing.
Wait. Yeah, just third.
Just this one.
Five total.
All right, so we got two more to go, is what you're telling me?
Well, I think at least this one would ordinarily come next, but we'll see.
I like to use
back in action.
That's it.
Now, how that happened? The wheel spun around. And started to do one of these.
Got it.
See how it's starting to beat on that cable. You see, that's why.
Just make sure.
Just keep your wheel out so that the cable isn't going to be into that. You know, getting into that altercation like that.
And then I'm going to go in and look for a basket. I finally took the kid's seat off the back, so I'm going to see if there's a basket that fits on instead.
Alexander can help you out with it.
Great.
All right. Now, that guy came in specifically asking about the BMX boy. The guy on that hydraulic. This break over here. Yeah, he said, you know, is there a guy by the name of BMX boy that works here? I really want to meet him.
That's a shame.
I wanted to compare pants with him. What kind of pants does he wear?
I wear shorts.
You don't wear one-piece Lycra outfit? And then he was also looking at possible some hairstyles that he was looking to share with you.
Yeah, well, my hairstyle now is all natural.
Okay.
It's called chlorine in bed.
Chlorine in bed?
Yep.
I had a little eau de bae last night on my hair.
That's amazing.
Eau de bae?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's good stuff, man. Good stuff. It is. I know, he twisted the crap out of that thing. I don't know how that got so bent. Save that app, that nut. All right, so here we go to do this, I'll have you know. No, I would never. I want, you know what I'm literally looking for? I'm looking for when Carhartt makes a pair of Lycra. That's what I'm looking for. That would be styling.
Amazing.
All right. Well, he's giving us a little bit of a challenge on that, on what's going on. His front brake is seized up solid. I'm not sure if somebody maybe, he said he took the brake off, he took the wheel off.
Yeah.
I got a feeling maybe if we take the wheel off and smush them apart, we'll be in business. I loosened up the wheel.
Oh, okay, all right.
Fix up Gant, this guy here, get these guys done, and then we'll see what we can do about that. He said he took the wheel off, so I'm guessing that's what it is. But the way he came in here like a house of fire, thinking that he owned the joint.
He did.
you caught on to that one too.
All right, we're going for it here with this thing. Onto here was probably solid, and I don't know how far down it's going to be solid, but we're going to find out. Be able to make it, I think you're going to be able to see some hole in there. I think I might change the blade, go to a little bit shorter blade. Let's see what we got. Okay, I need a little shorter blade. I'm going a little shorter blade, so that way I'm not going to hit here. I still got a little ways to go. We are seeing some light at the end of the pump. How you doing? Having fun yet? You jogged, huh? How'd that go? I don't know about that jogging stuff. That's work. Riding a bike's much better. You get there a lot faster, that's for sure. Blue Meanie, what's going on? The Blue Meanie. Of this,
you bugged or what? All right, we need a little blow here. How's it look? Looks like they got a slip going on down that thing.
I don't know. I gave it the whole blade. I'm cutting the whole thing. That's a good question. Can we get that out of there? I don't know. I want to see how far down I was going. I'm going pretty far. Take it easy. I'm gonna give it another little shot. Beto was saying, that solid part seems to be starting to break away from the edge of the conference. You know what else I'm thinking is maybe we should try slicing it from the other way. Come down. We have our guest is in the house. You guys didn't even know we were having a special guest today, did you? I didn't lie to them. I just didn't tell them all the truth. Cheryl!
Back in the house!
Mershot. Dorskin is in the house. Cheryl.
Hi.
Is going to be talking. Wait, you got a mic for Cheryl there?
Yep, absolutely.
You know what I can do is I can give you, would you like to talk with Cheryl about interviewing Cheryl on what's going on with her?
You concept? Stay with her. No, you know exactly more. Better, you're better prepped than
I am.
Well,
I'm not as prepped
like
as you
sure.
think. You like those things?
Color coordinated.
You
is this a new mic?
It works.
That is this your new stuff?
No.
Yep, you're good to go. Hi there.
So come and sit down with me, Cheryl.
Okay.
So Cheryl is also on our live show. She asked if she'd like to come in. She's given us she's got a little promotion going on. She's got a little promotion going on with her camera and her, there we go. Oh, you got yourself a little,
I
yeah,
have my
there
sign,
we go. Hold
my
it
name
nice
is
and
so
still
long.
There we go. We didn't quite have, you know, we've been working on our new software and whatnot. And we're gonna be able to like put up like parts like Cheryl's coming in so we could like put up your Facebook page and be able to break to that. And
great.
We can start to be able to have different producers and different productions of different screens that we could go on to. And you know, that way we can maybe even get like certain commercials going on and we can break to a commercial, and it's getting exciting with some of our new software stuff. But anyway,
excellent.
Cheryl's here to, she's got a photo safari.
Yeah, I'm teaching, I love teaching photography. I teach.
All right, you can get that. You got that, son of a?
I teach at college, I teach online, I teach in person. So I also do these photo safaris, which, brings a group of people together, and any kind of camera from a smartphone to a point and shoot to a DSLR. I brought some stuff. We want to talk camera stuff lately, but you know, photography is a tool for communicating and seeing, and I'm really good at teaching people how to communicate that way. So the safaris are really great because when you live here in the Hamptons, you can get a pass, and I can take you to places that you normally
So you're going to take these people in your car to various exotic spots on our Barrier Beach Island, is what
right.
you were telling me.
The Barrier Beach Island, I love that. I gotta.
And exclusive places that some of the locals don't even know about.
Oh yeah, absolutely. They're beautiful places that.
So it's going to be mostly wildlife. Are we picture wildlife or landscapes, or are we going for?
It's more rustic. You think of the Hamptons as duney and beachy, but it's earthy. So it might be egrets, it might be seagrass, it might be funky under the Ponequog Bridge kind of stuff, rocks
okay.
and boats and.
But we're going for the natural deal, or do we take it to the photo lab with this? Do you teach these guys anything with after
production?
No, the safari
is just in camera, but I find out everyone's manual before, and one of the goals is to go off automatic, and even with a smartphone, to teach you how to use the camera to best get the picture. So, but everything's in camera. For an after post-processing, you'd have to book me for a private lesson, which I do lots of those too, online and in person.
It's cool.
Yeah, it's really cool. Hello.
Hi guys, how are you? We do. You are heading in the right direction. Alexandra is inside as well as Tony Jones. You're welcome. Hi.
Hello.
So what did you bring with us today?
I just brought some toys. I brought, this is my safari style sling bag. For guys, I guess you'd use a backpack, but I really like that. I also have, well, I brought some cameras. This is a sling. It's a really good strap for safari-style camera walking. This is my pro camera.
Is this your camera of choice? Is this like your go-to?
This is my go-to if I'm shooting professionally. This is a lens hood, for those that don't know. It's an essential tool for point-and-shoots or DSLRs. This is called a DSLR. This is my go-to professional camera. But people on safaris are also going to be using iPhones or smartphones. I mean, I don't know where I put mine, but...
A 5D.
That's a 5D. I'm waiting for the new one to come out. And then I just got this. This is called a bridge camera. This is fantastic. It's a little miniature camera that I always have in my bag because my smartphone, which I use an iPhone, can't give me enough of the zoom. So I always have another camera with me. So this is a really sophisticated point and shoot, but they make them bigger. And if you want to know what kind of camera to get, you can email, put a note on Bart's YouTube.
Or email
station.
You at, I'm sure we can get you right through your website as well.
Yeah. Good. Very accessible. So anyway, these are some toys I brought.
So if they want to go on this safari photo shoot,
yes.
They contact you, and it's going to be your first safari photo shoot is going to be one week from today.
No, it's going to be Thursday.
This coming up Thursday. Okay, gotcha.
I don't want to do them on the weekends. Too crowded here.
Too crowded.
But, you know, if some of your listeners are interested, we could do a biking safari.
That would be a lot of fun.
I think that would be a lot of fun.
And also do that during the week and maybe during the evening or something to that effect.
Late afternoon, 5 to 7, well, we want to make sure. Yeah, something like 4 to 7:30. That's what I have it now. 4 to 7:30 is a good time. You get some sunset shots, people away from the beach. You'd be surprised. You come in the middle of the week, the places I take you to, there's no people. It's really amazing.
There are some great spots, I'm sure.
Yeah, we'll actually have to talk shop because, I mean, you've lived here all your life, so you probably know some things.
You know, the nice part about when you're getting down towards the bay and whatnot, a lot of people don't realize this, is that it's public land up to the high tide line. So you can continue to keep on strolling along anybody's back, you know, oceanfront and the beaches, and you can get right up to the close of the dunes. I mean, you know, you don't want to intrude on their privacy or whatnot, but, you know, seeing the backside or the front side of some of these houses are, as well as when you're on the bay side as well, it's just absolutely amazing, these houses. And some of the setups that they have and the beautiful landscaping and, you know, just their whole the hardscape with the pool and the lawn and the, you know, they make some really, there's some pretty fancy houses out here that you can see from the other side when you're on a boat or on the bay or on the ocean as well. I'm sure you're seeing a lot of that.
Yeah.
But you're more into that. I was looking at your photos the other day, and sometimes you've got some, I was on your Instagram page. You can get a little abstract as well with some of this stuff and start blurring out. And do you do that in the after, or do you do that through the lens?
In camera, no. I teach people how to do that in camera, and that's one of the thrills of teaching someone. When you can see that, because with digital photography, you see everything in the background. When you see how you can blur the background and focus, like say you're on a flower, sunflower, in focus, everything blurred, people are just like, wow. So it's very hands-on learning how to create beautiful pictures. I have an Instagram feed that I'm just really getting into. I love Instagram. So much fun.
It is. I like Instagram too. That is my social media.
Actually, I'll post today on Instagram. I have to take a picture of me here.
There you go.
Then I'll post that today that I'm here with you.
There you go.
But yeah, I think we should do a bike safari.
That sounds like a plan. I like that idea. I like that idea a lot.
So, you know, you might want to take a smaller camera.
All right. What else you got for me, Cheryl? In our promotion of our thing, we're going on. What else? What else is exciting in your life lately? Got anything else for me? I haven't seen you in a month or so.
Well, let's see. I don't know. I'm really busy working.
That's good.
My busy time doing portraits. I was just accepted to Getty Stock, which is a really big career deal. I'm also on this other show, but I won't even advertise it.
No, that's okay. Let's hear it.
This Week in Photo, which is a really fun photo podcast.
Photo podcast, and that's we can get to that through the web.
Yeah, it's TWIT, This Week in Photo.
This week, I'm familiar with TWIT, as a matter of fact.
TWIT, yeah, I was on last week. We talked about Taylor Swift and a lot of Adobe Photoshop stuff. CC just had an update, so I'm like really into Photoshop, and I teach it, so it was a fun show. That was last week. Be on again in August.
Cool. We're going to check that out as well.
All good stuff.
All right. Sounds great to me, Cheryl, baby. Thank you for coming on down and by. And we're going to wait, is this for me to keep?
Yeah.
Oh, cool. Because we're going to put that up on our bulletin board over here.
All righty.
And that way we can continue to promote my girlfriend, Cheryl.
Thanks, Bike and Kite. I'm going to get off the air.
Something. Oh, yeah. Ooh, it gets hot on that stage there. Mm. Sweat.
Am I off the air now?
Well, if you push that down, it's give that to her.
He won't be off.
Yeah, we're always broadcasting.
Hi, how are you?
There you go. Thank you for coming, Cheryl.
Thank you.
Yeah, no, exactly. It'd be great for you. Hey, keep our local gal going. You're awesome, girl.
Enjoy the weekend. Went out chasing on.
All right, there we go.
The girls good
for you. You guys are being helped.
Yes.
Cool.
Thank you.
All right, back at you. Photo safari on bike. Happy. Oh, I am very concerned.
Adam, okay.
Whether or not he's come out. Cheryl, have fun.
I mean, we can, but that he already paid for it. Nobody can get even about 45 minutes and a half hours.
Okay. But did you teach him? Or did you basically go to the office by himself?
Heck, give her a teach. Like, does Molly know?
All right. Let's see what's going to happen. I don't know.
Hi, how are you?
Yes.
How long are you going to take in the lunch for?
2 days.
What's that?
No, I'm just joking.
The charge of 2 days, it's going to be 5 gigabytes.
Do you think that thing is going to come out of there?
Where I can come back.
Maybe that was.
The lines, like, right there.
Yeah.
I guess
it's
where I am.
All right, let's give that a little crack, a little screwdriver. Okay. It's what?
Split there. Split on the inside there.
That ain't coming out. I might be able to separate it apart from there a little bit, but I don't think so.
Wow.
You know what I'm thinking about? I'm thinking about slicing it the other way as well.
Because
I can cut. I'm pretty far all the way down that whole shooting neck right now. I'm afraid that I'm going to start hitting the frame.
Okay.
Now, if I can get the other side, if I can get slice that down this way, and then maybe put the wrench on there and try to slice the whole thing off. What? It's solid up to about here. Everybody just keeps saying that it isn't. You know, there's no. It's just because I get a hole through there doesn't mean, you know, I can grip onto this. I can get it so tight. I can get onto this with a pipe wrench. And not a problem twisting.
Seeing how you sliced it like that, could you grab it now and control it? try it?
That's what I think we're going to do. And let's see what happens.
Who's on the phone?
Put the wheel back on there and we'll put it on the ground. What's that? I got the pipe wrench here. Hold this thing. Let's switch sides.
Hi, Daddy. It's me and Mommy. It's 11:05, but the bike is here. So I'm going to invite you to come home. I'm going to call you and see if you have anything out there. All right, see you soon. Bye. Thanks for coming.
Hey, good morning. It's coming out. It seems to be. Beautiful bank. Check this out. We got that out. Motor 20 is right over here.
I'm going to get the bikes from you guys.
Thank you. All right. You need one of them right away? We can get one. See that. All right. We're making progress, boys. Cool. We are making progress.
Do you have a MasterCard or Visa for Discover?
No.
Now, old Mr. Two Arms.
I don't. You have a... Or a personal
old check. Mr. Two Arms,
so
things need to be fixed.
Okay, so we're coming. We don't have anything
break
besides
over here.
That.
Your buddy.
Inside, even for the cash deposit.
In a little bit. He wants to see. He wants to see what... Old Mr. Two Arms wants to see Mr. Mark come back. He's waiting. He wants me to give him a shout. You didn't get a good shot? I didn't want to look, to tell you the truth. I'll be honest with you, man. I really was not looking. Okay. Oh, you missed something. You did. You missed it. Oh, boy. All right. We're going to look down the hall and see how far I went with that.
You're not going to ride that.
No, you're not. Yeah.
What are you talking about? Why did he get blocked? He didn't get blocked. Did somebody, son of a, did you block somebody this morning? So I get blocked for saying the truth about what you said about the economy turning around? Great, I guess you lost a supporter. Later.
I didn't block him.
You didn't block?
I didn't touch anybody this morning.
Yeah, so I don't know. Maybe he's got, maybe, you know, maybe Google blocked him. It's not got nothing to do with us. I didn't see what the heck he was talking about. I don't know who it was, what the guy's name was. What? When's the puppet show? I don't know. All right. I put my phone to get to the light, and then I got waylaid. I do that all the time. All right. Now I can look at that.
There's not like girls and guys bikes, right? It's just bike, retro bikes, right?
Do you have guys bikes?
No, not for us. I have a brother who's also
going to go. A little shout with the Fossozzo. I think we're making progress. I think we're getting it out. When is today? About the show?
Give me that.
Nice.
So Unisex.
Ladies.
Okay, so then fine. So now that I'm driving you,
oh, see, sorry. So, can you have a unisex bike?
I told you.
No, you really don't.
He said there's unisex. Oh, baby, on your foot.
Okay, we're gonna come back. We'll be.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Sauce down there and see what happens. We're working it. All right. So, everybody wants to see what's going on with that. How do we do? Where are we? You're still on this phase, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's get some wheels going on that thing. All right, let me put this in the sun so I can see something better. Slicing it the other way might help us out too a little bit. Yeah. Just can't quite get the fold over it. Crap out of that. I know it. My channel, Bike Labor. I know it. All right.
Show you what we have.
Okay.
Oh,
carry more gear than we can.
Never have enough gear. All right, now, another idea I got is maybe possibly flipping it upside down and putting it in the vise.
The other thing that looks like needs is a little basket.
We'll try that out. The frozen chilled zone ain't gonna cut it. Finish line came up with this stuff called the frozen chilled zone. It's basically liquid nitrogen in a can. And then you put it on the thing you're supposed to freeze the. All right, Makito, you ready for this?
I got it.
Lift it on in there. I'll clamp it. You lift it. Be careful. There might be sauce coming spooching out of there. Watch it. Don't answer. Now, wait a minute. Now, go to your. Try to get it. Yeah. Hold that thing in there. You gotta come there with it. Oh, yeah. Beat. Alright, give it a little twist-a-roo. Oh boy. The slice?
Yeah.
All the way.
Oh.
The distance of that blade.
So what?
I think we got to go the other
side.
Yeah. Yeah. I think that's about, we're not getting, we got nowhere on that. I mean, that thing did not, I expected
it. Well.
It crushed it, but it didn't do what we wanted it to do. That's the damn sure. All right, let's go. I'm going to go back into the rack. We're going to slice it down the other side. If at first you don't succeed, curse a little and try again. All right. Now, what have we got going on? You got that going. We got this thing that we're going to need to do later on. We got to get a tire on this thing. I gotta think a little bit on that.
Thank you.
I'm good, and you?
Good. Can you guys, if we have two little floats to blow up, can we...
You got it in the name of Justin. Justice. You got it. All right, back at us. A little float action here. Come on over here to the carpet area so we don't have fun. We're all drunk up. Pizza slices. You're welcome. There you go. Have fun. Enjoy your slice. There's quite a delay now, huh? Son of a big delay. Doesn't go now. I'm giving up. All right, back to the drawing board, back to its spot. I'm going to keep saucing it for a little bit. Not totally giving up, but I'm giving up for today. That's all. We've exhausted everything with our sawzall. Am I beaten up? Maybe. Did I lose the battle? No. Okay. Sometimes you win some, sometimes you lose. We'll put her back over here in her hole for a little bit. Give it some more sauce. Give it a little shot of sauce. Put the sawzall away, and I guess we're back on to everybody's been waiting for. That beautiful bike. That beautiful bike that the guy does absolutely no maintenance to. Sweating. Milwaukee sawzall. Doing it. I've had this tool. Oh my gosh. This thing's been with me a long time. Back down to the cellar. Actually, I'm going to leave that there for now. We'll give it another shot after we'll give it another try. That one seems pretty welded in there though. All right, that's garbage. All right, we'll leave this to here, leave this to here. All right, let's see what we got going on. Good morning.
Hey, do you have a kite string?
Straight in that back door, see Tony, Joe, or Alexandra. Pretty fancy-ass bicycle this gentleman's got. Now, the question at hand here is that he took the wheel off. And take the pod out. Yeah, that's what you're gonna have to do. Sometimes this gets a little tight. That might be a little tight. If you want, you know, well, when you take that cover off, is both sides are not working?
Yeah. I get one click
and then. Nothing after that. It's gonna have to, you're gonna have to get in there. With any of these types of brakes, hydraulic disc brakes, is when you do take your wheel off, do not hit your brake. because it's just going to smush them. It's just going to smush it together, and you're not going to be able to do what you got to do, which I think is what happened to this dude. Now we're going to take our hydraulic piston press, wherever the heck that is. Easy there, son. Easy there, son. I know where I got one. Marco. Yes, no, maybe. Where's our hydraulic tools? Kit, where are those little, you know what I'm talking about? Where are those? Hi, ladies.
Hi. We're looking at that orange bike out front.
Uh-huh.
For her.
Uh-huh. Come on with me. We're going to put you with Tony Joe. Tony Joe is our Brooklyn bicycle specialist. Tony Joe, this young lady here is interested in the orange. I think it's out front for this young lady. Now we're talking. Nice, and there's our piston press. Just what we need in our kit. Park PP 1.2, looks like this. And we're gonna put it in there.
Hi, Tony.
Hi, Kit.
Hi.
And then we're gonna put it back in. And that ain't gonna work either.
I was pumping up some of my tires, and this pump, which has been working great for years, appeared no longer to be able to inflate the tires. I couldn't figure out what to do. And I think it's, can you see the little rubber thing out here?
Yeah.
I think that's the seal is no longer.
Alright,
see, so juice is coming out of it all.
Okay.
So, anyway. I don't know if it's, I don't think this is fixable.
Mm-hmm.
But maybe the big man, I mean, it might
be. Bart.
Yeah.
Take a look at this pump.
I've never seen it happen to a pump before, but it's the seal there, you see that seal poke?
Ellie can help you inside.
Oh, yeah.
So when you. When
so
you
it,
pump,
doesn't, it doesn't, it doesn't do anything.
It doesn't force
it's
the
not
air into time. So maybe that's the end of the pump. I don't know.
Let's open that up. We
help you guys out?
She's looking for a bike.
Cool. Talk to me on what kind of, or style, or, you know.
A road bike?
A road bike.
A
hybrid bike. We got something like that.
Sure.
Hello, Bike and Kite, Bike Man for You. Absolutely. Yeah, bring it in. You might have to leave it for a little bit. We'll see how busy we are. But yes, we can do you flat. Absolutely. Same locations for the last 39 years. Yeah, there is a little, we had a little change of sign, that's true. But we haven't changed our location. Mm-hmm. Well, it still says Bike and Kite out front, but Bike Man for You is the main prominent part, yeah. We'll see you in a little bit. 5 o'clock. Yeah. See you later. Try it. Well, try it. Let's see what happens. Mark. Follow this through here. I think I fixed this guy's bump. All right, hybrid bicycle. Medium width wheel.
So what happened was a little rubber seal in there that popped out. So the all the air was coming out through this lever and not. I mean, just test it on an actual.
Yeah,
tire,
like what we'll do is put a helmet on your head and you can actually take it for a spin if you'd like. Excuse me? Okay, I understand.
Yeah, it's working great now. Cool. All right, we're all set.
You're looking at $365. Next up from that, we would be going into a one with suspension. Again, a hybrid bike. Mm-hmm. Well, again, it's a comfort thing. I just, strongly recommend that you take it for a spin. Work? Maybe you can come back and, now we get into, suspension, a little bit more comfort, a little bit more money, now you're at, another $100, you're up to a $500 bike. Maybe sport fitness might be the category in that hybrid style. Again, it's in that under $400. Just a hair thinner. But you can see how the bar is a little bit flatter, so you're going to be pitching yourself over a little bit more. Might not be as comfortable. But in that same price point, $380-ish. I don't know if cruiser, I heard something, not going too far. I mean, is single speed, is that, No. Yeah. Fix his pump,
If I wanted a bike but you don't have the right color,
mm-hmm.
How long does it take to get?
If it's in stock, it shouldn't be long. 2 days,
okay.
3 days.
Do those come in other colors?
That bike, that first one I showed you does not. The second one does.
Okay.
The first one is a one color only.
I'm gonna go check
that
the bikes.
Excuse me?
Is that blue color?
Yeah, that.
And then those black and white ones come.
Those are the two colors that comes in, a black or a white, in the ladies. I'm going with the step-through style frame. I'm assuming that's what you're looking for.
I
understand.
Can I bring him in the store?
You can. All right, Makito. I don't know what's going on with this thing. What's that? I tried, as best I could. I got a feeling that the pads, I'm going to take these pads out of here and see what the story is with that. I just want to take a look at them. But it looks like the thing might have been rubbing for a while. How's those shifters coming along?
Are they gonna make it?
Oh yeah. It's gonna need new
cables. You know what we're competing with, and why we're not out of control, is the fact that it's a beautiful day.
What about when everybody goes home?
Yeah. No, did not go, baby G. Doesn't look too good for my buddy Spencer.
How do you get stuck in there?
Time.
How are you?
I'm doing well, and yourself?
Very good, thanks.
How may we help you out this morning? Picking up a bike?
I got two.
You got two bikes here? Yes. Liking that idea. Be right with you.
Okay.
What's that? What kind of brake fluid is this? Mineral. Color. Alright. Yeah, we got a couple of bikes in this joint. All right, do me a big favor, Tom. Get out of the way.
Hey, Mark.
This tube, guys, looking for 25.
Thank you.
awesome. Cool, I'll be right with you. Let me give this to my daughter.
I'm just looking at the alignment of the wheel. It's just this thing is going wrong.
Yeah, this thing is a little funky.
Come on in.
Good morning. That seat, that feel comfortable?
Yeah, the seat was comfortable. Oil spray, right? Yeah.
Okay. In the right height for you?
Yeah.
Okay. Awesome. You gotta get it.
Yeah.
Cool. Okay. What was that?
Put it here.
Okay. As you get riding, Isabel, the cables are going to stretch. So probably in about 3 or 4 weeks, come back, minor adjustment, just normal wear.
How do you switch the gears on?
In it, as your that question, as you, are your arms comfortable?
Yeah.
Because this can, these got, they can go up a little bit or down a little bit if you want to.
You want it a little higher?
No, I like
higher.
Okay. And then as you get the seat too, we can adjust if you find you need to go.
271.56, Tom.
On the downstroke.
You don't want to be in straight.
Yeah.
You don't want to be over.
You know, eating knees. So this can be adjusted a little bit more as you get comfortable. It can go up.
Yeah.
As you're pedaling forward, this right shifter controls the internal hub. This shifter back here, which controls the inside, this back hub here. This is a grip shift as you're pedaling forward. You're in the one position now. As you're pedaling forward, you turn it away from you, it'll go to two. Pedal more, it'll go to three. And that's, depending upon, make it easier as you're pedaling, it's mainly the rotations per minute. And then if you need it harder, you're pedaling forward, you pull towards you to go back to two and back to one. When you go to stop, Isabel, engage both brakes at the same time, and then just step off. All right? Cool. I'm going to have Mark just check the air pressure on the tires.
Bill,
Sebastian, we
give you a hand putting them in. Enjoy your day. You're welcome. Thank you.
Hey, good morning. Let me write you one inside, ladies.
Be right with you, folks.
Yeah, you as well.
No problem. Traffic cop around here. What's happening? Good, good. You? Inside item, I don't think there is. I think we'd probably be changing the saddle itself.
I don't want to change the saddle. The saddle's not really the problem.
Well, okay. Seats are adjustable, like this, fore and aft, as well as up and down. That's the way seats are adjusted. So, you know, it's tough for me to say, oh, is this right? You know, it's all personal preference. You know, the saddle that you have right now that's on here, it's an okay saddle. The cover, you know, we got a cover on there. It's a pretty good hammock type style saddle. There's a suspension in there. It's got pretty good spring. The cover over the top is definitely added gel cover. With those things that I just talked about, I mean, you know, does that seem to, you know? Okay.
But I mean, I have that problem if I sit down here. It's not. It's
if you sit.
Bone.
You got a bony butt.
I've got a bony butt.
Well. Maybe we should think about a different saddle, like I said before, you know? I'll be happy to warrant, refund on this and go to the next saddle. I got no problem with that. you know? But maybe you might want to try a little different salve. Come over to my seat trying station. What's your first name? Alisa, okay. Gare, you ready for this? I'm gonna leave you in charge here. All of these saddles can go into this machine. All right? I'm just gonna take this one here and put this into here. You know what? If it works, you know, who cares what it looks like? That's just my philosophy. Try that out and see what you think. Young man, how are you doing?
Good. So we changed this yesterday?
I changed it? Or you changed it?
You changed it.
And it went flat again.
Yeah, and I think you said, because I had just gotten a new tube in it, and you said it was leaking by the valve.
Mm-hmm.
So something's not.
Something ain't right.
Something ain't right, right?
Yeah, something
ain't
right. And
also, I'm just going to leave it here if that's okay.
Oh, you want to leave it? Okay. You don't want to wait for it?
No.
All right.
Tube by the rent?
Yeah.
Okay. Ellie!
Okay. Something. We might have had a defective tube in there. I'm looking for tickets. Here we go. We're going to find out. We're going to get to the bottom of it. We're going to warranty it for you.
Hey, George, I said to be
able to. Uh-huh. Okay.
And it was still leaking. You said something around the valve.
Right.
You put a new one in yesterday.
And right.
It went 4 miles.
And it went flat again. Okay. Give me name and phone number. Can you borrow that seat and go ride around for a little bit? Let's see what happens. Yeah, let me see if I don't know if that post is going to work on there, but let me see what happens. Your first name is?
Scott.
All right, Scott, we'll see you later. Sorry for the inconvenience. Yeah. They're here to look at that at a bicycle that I got that we've been trying to get the seat post out of for about a week and a half, 2 weeks.
All right. So you've got them covered. Isabel, I'm going to go inside and write you up. And then 6, another at half bar.
We went to drastic measures today to cut it. Well, we were hoping we were going to be at least try to get the old one out. I'll show you where we're at. It's not looking too good. The corrosion just got in there and just welded it solid. You're welcome. Come on over. George Spencer, right?
Yeah.
So we're in process of trying to get it out. We've cut it. We've been on this for a little bit. We pried it out, trying to get jute down in the side. We slid it on the side, and it's down, you know, this seat post goes down into here. So, I don't know, almost at the point of no return. We're still gonna give it another little crack here. We went to the masters. You know, went to the absolute extreme. I mean, we're kind of like, you know, I talked to Gypsy. I said, we're going to go to the extreme. And she said, you know, well, we got to do what we got to do. I mean, it was definitely, you know, that was the first step, like we talked about.
Yeah.
We got to see if we can get that undone. I think we might be looking at a little different bike, is what I'm thinking. A new bike.
There's nowhere to stick another?
No. Good idea, but no. It's just not going to be strong enough to be able to handle what it needs to handle. I think I got it. You're looking for
tires.
Bike transportation, right?
These tires are...
You got it back and forth to work?
Thank you very much.
You don't do off-road? Do you go off-road at all, or do you know?
I'm doing the North Fork Triathlon tomorrow.
And it's more of a thinner tire.
Very short bike.
On the road. It's a big frame. I'm looking at how long it's going to
get. I know. The run is like 3.5 hours.
Yeah. Let me get that over at my warehouse. And
that could be a good option.
Oh, yeah.
It would be the price of that bicycle would then what it would cost to put fix this and
'88,
and it's in really good shape.
Wow.
Let me see what I can do here, and then let me get that other bike over here, and within the next day or so I can get you 339 with 646339. Thank you, guys. Sorry, be the giver of bad news.
Minimum 40, max 65 PSI. Okay. And they just stood up, you're all set. Bye, guys. Stay well. Stay cool. If you want to ride bike,
you
all right. And then,
not going to fit in there,
so
right?
Come back,
but you'd still like to try it for a week.
No.
Oh.
Just go around for a little bit.
Okay. I'm going to put it on.
Mark,
I'm going to take
free?
Her post and put it on
yes,
that.
Can you help
seat.
Christina and Isabel put this in their car? Thank you, Mark.
You're welcome. For once, my
beautiful. We like that. Thanks, ladies. Have fun. Enjoy. Happy riding.
You know Ray from my cookie?
Yeah. Oh no, huh? How old is she? What's that? Oh, I'm just dandy now. Everybody's different. Put that post back in. Let's take a 14 millimeter wrench. Take a pair of wire cutters and cut that off. Whatever it wants. Here we go.
They're
right.
Checking
in. Braces are more, their pressure is more forward than.
I hear ya. No. You know how to raise and lower that, right, Gare?
You're welcome. Oh, Makito.
I wonder if he stored his bike upside down. Oh, it's definitely a problem. No. I can't even get the damn thing in there now.
What if we re-blade it?
I think we're gonna have to.
Is it possible to squeeze it so hard that you just can't? It's about a minute.
All right, guys, good luck. We'll see you later. Yeah. All right, I guess we're going to bleed them out and try over again, Marquito. Take it away. I'll give it to you. Have the DOT. Ooh, it's hot out there, boy, today. All right, let's get some computer action going here. We need a little power. And then we got a tube to we got problems with tubes. We got 700 by 25C. Give me the laptop cord there, please. Not happy. The one that works for that laptop that I got out there. Yeah, thank you. And I got a feeling we got another one. Flat tire. We're going to leave that to Makito. Makito, the expert in... We've become experts over the wintertime on fluid brakes, hydraulics. Yeah. And... all right, we got to let that boot up. All right, so now, while we're at it, here we go. It looks to me like we're going to have a serious problem with you. And we're going to have to double check, triple check, quadruple check every single tube that goes into just about anything. Especially when it is a 700 by 20 to 25C Kenda tube. Well, I have that in my box of goodies. And we are definitely going to have to be talking, and we'll be making a specific video on it in regards to who, what, where, and how, and why. say it's not dead now. Okay. They are a pain. Hydraulic brakes are a pain. Danny Pantera. No, Guitar Fool 5931. They are. Daily Motion Video. Oh, BMX. All right. It is a nice trick. All right, here we go. Let's see what happens with this flat tire. If this is blown up by the... Now, this happens to be a smooth bore, and it seems like the smooth bores, but it doesn't much matter. Smooth bore, threaded bore, doesn't much matter. They all have been seeming to have a bunch. Now, this one here is probably no exception. Now, the ones that we have right now are under the box and brand of Giant. But it is a Kenda tube. Now, maybe he just got a flat tire, but I kind of doubt. And it is right at, well, there's a little bit of crap going on right at that valve. Like we kind of thought there was. What happened? You got a little taste? What did the juice? Well, maybe that. Oh, so maybe that solves our problem. It was just too much stuff. Maybe the heat. He said something about that heat, but you know, 100-degree barn should not have anything that should not deal with that. I mean, that's the whole reason why they got hydraulic brakes to begin with. You want to come up?
Joni.
Question. Yes, Joni, baby.
I am back.
You are back. No, you cannot, but I'll tighten that up. What else? Loose compared to your front one? They should be both pretty close to even, but sometimes this one's going to be a little bit more longer pull because this cable is this long and this cable is only this long. I see what you're saying. All right, hold your bike. You want it flat up like that, right?
Yeah.
You know, we've been changing them around. Oh man, we're on constant. We this one's not bad the way they squish apart. But you know what the big problem is with these? Well, you move your hand. You got a little case. My case doesn't go. You know, I got one of them. I got one of them Otterbox tails. It's too fat. Well, plus, this is also the 6 plus. But they make one that's bigger.
Yeah,
but
I
this doesn't make it in there.
No.
We've been.
It's the Delta.
We've been. We sell the Delta.
Oh, you do?
Yeah. We got them in different sizes. They are good. I agree with you. All right.
Somebody gave it
to
a house present.
Oh, nice. All right. Now brakes. Let's see what we can do here. We're going to take up a little bit on that adjusting barrel here.
But I was like coming back from Montauk Highway going, I don't think the right brake should be the one that doesn't work as well. I have a friend who's a kid who I watch.
Oh, yeah? No. Oh, it's scary. All right, that takes care of that. Next. Feel them both, so that they're both even now, or pretty close to even. For what? That little quickie is nothing. What did I do yesterday? I can't remember. Okay.
Can we do any better on?
No.
I have,
no.
You know I have to.
Absolutely. You can ask all you want.
And if I pay in greenbacks?
That's good. We like that.
We can do that?
We can do that. No, I didn't say nothing. I don't know about that.
Neither do I.
It's included. All right, here we go with that.
Okay.
Joni, enjoy the day, huh?
You too. Thank you.
Better? This thing here, it just adjusts the row of the brake itself. Well, it wasn't in here for that.
No, yeah.
Perfect. Perfect. Done. So we undid the bleeder screw. It let some of the spooch came out of there. And then put the bleeder screw back in, and we're golden. So either something expanded or something came out or something. But we're good. All right, so that covers that. All right. Next. So, this guy's tube. We put a new tube in there. And yes, it was shot. They're all starting to blow right at the valve vulcanization. You want to come in tight? You can see how this one's starting to bulge around that. Problem. Next. Slit right at this. Again, smooth bore, 48. Next. Threaded. Another smooth bore, 48, same spot. We're in trouble. Hi, guys.
How you doing?
Hi.
Doing well, and you?
Pretty good. So I think you talked to my dad last week. You were talking about getting lights either, I think you were deciding between just normal cruisers or, like, you know, a hybrid that gives you a little more flexibility. So we sent this down to check out the options.
Gotcha. What's your first name?
Derek.
Derek, okay, Derek. I'm Bart. This is Tony Joe. Tony?
Yeah. We've actually done some work on my road bike. So
Derek, looking for some bikes for the house. I showed his father a couple of bikes, hybrid versus cruiser versus... Are these guys with you? Okay. And they're back on the reconnaissance. The father had came in earlier, and that's where I'm at. Don't know about single speed, don't know hybrid, don't. You're in good hands, guys.
Good morning, everybody. I'm gonna have a bad day.
So, I've got, this is all this week, okay? One, two, three, four, five. And then now when we pull them out of the box, we're checking it out accordingly. And we pulled this one out of the box, and it's starting to separate right at that same spot. So that's number six. This one we found before we put it in. And we're continually, now we're watching it all the way around, okay? So it is, we are now at DEPCON 5. Double red probationary alert on these two. What do I do? What am I doing? How am I doing? I'm not sure. For now, we're just double checking, triple checking any kind of road bike too. We'll inflate it. We'll inflate it a little bit.
Actually, just a little bit.
Not enough. Get it inflated pretty good. Get it, you know, fairly large. And make sure that you're getting that dip inside of that, where that vulcanization. And then you're going to look at it real tight. Double check that vulcanization where that is. Now give it a little pull, give it a little push, and check it very carefully. Because I've got to double check this spot right here. Like, hopefully? That's where we're at. I don't know how good this is. Kenda is the world's largest manufacturer of tubes, and everybody's using them. So, relax. Hey, deal with it. We got to deal with it. Excuse me.
So what do you need, Al? Do you need me for anything, or? So let's hope for the best on this. And now we got a threaded one. Threaded one seems to be better than the other. So we're gonna start to really double check. And triple check. And I recommend that you guys double, triple check if you're using 700, like 20 to 25. 48, seems to be the 48 millimeter levels. Do me a favor, Al. Write this guy up here. All right, we adjust his front brake $30. And call him up. No, I want 30 on there. We were gonna bleed it through all of this. I was on the high end. And if you could call him too, Allie, all right? Tell him that it's, you know, up and ready to go. Yeah, I will. These guys are here for air, I heard.
How are you guys doing today?
Good, you?
Good, good.
So, the bike's been in storage for a little bit.
You've been doing this for a while?
Yeah.
How's your day going so far?
Not bad at all.
What does it look like?
What does it look like here? I don't know. It looks like I'm going to have to put it up in the rack so that I can spin it and put air in it at the same time. Because when it's this low, we could have a tendency to blow the tire off the rim, maybe. And we don't want to do that. Bike is in good shape. You're storing it in a good spot. Keep up the good work. No. No, it's dry. It's, you know, yeah, it's a little dusty, but, you know, hey. I'm thinking so, yeah. Over a period of time, rubber's porous, it's going to leak out.
Good.
We're good, Gary?
Yeah, we're good, Bart. You've done it again. You've solved another bike problem.
Another ass problem.
Another good ass problem.
All right, so what are we doing? We're going to give you a warranty on that. We're going to refund on this cover, and then we're going for a new seat. Is that what I'm hearing?
Right, but okay. Don't give me a full refund on this because we use
it. I'm not worried about that. I can get it from my guys. I'm not worried about that at all. Allie, we got to see Allie, yeah.
What do I tell her?
I don't know. I'll be right in. Looking good, guys. Looking good. It's a nice bike. Barely new.
Really?
It's a nice bike. It's fairly new. It doesn't have a lot of mileage on it at all. It needed air badly, like we talked about. The gears are working. You got lubrication on your chain. You know what this bicycle needs to be done? Rud. 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 That's the past tense of ride. Rud. Needs to be rud.
Alright.
Park.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, guys. Have fun, all right?
Yep. How much is it for
the air? Air is free. Has been for 30 years. Hopefully going to continue to be there. Tony, Allie, how much is this seat cover? Okay. Good. So we had a new seat. We had a new seat at 60, and this was 30, so you owe me $30. Done. See you later. Have fun. Yeah, right. Thank you very much. You did the same. All right, folks.
All right.
Thanks, Skipper.
You're welcome. Take it easy.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Back to this flat. All right, so, like we're talking about, we got some serious problems with getting the tubes. What are we going to do?
Where he just walked out.
What's that?
Where the guy was just walked out.
He left you. He ain't back here, my dear. He's got to be up front somewhere. What's that? Where did it go? Did you call him?
Yeah.
Did you get him? This is the Domain 5 series by Trek. I'm not quite sure I'm a fan. It does look nice, but, you know, what's going on with this business here? You know, the OCLV carbon, it must be some sort of a shock system that it can, you know. Yeah. I just don't get that whole frame action, the way that's built like that and whatnot. Now, I got another one for you, Makita, while you're at it. What are these little holes? Why do we have those threaded Allen bolts inside of that frame right there? Why would it be on that side? Two sides. Now, I guess I'm assuming that maybe there should be some sort of a rack or something. Maybe there's an accessory or, yeah? Who knows? So there's a question for us. There's a question for everybody out there. Why does it have two threaded little holes on the back? Let me see. Where's my little baby Allen wrench? That one out here. I keep losing the one I tape out here. Why does that keep going back over there? So why does it have these little screw holes right there? Come right up. It's just a little itty bitty. It's a hole. Threaded. And I thought maybe you might be able to use it, like you said, for DI, but it's solid. It goes right in the hole. It's got to be for an accessory of some sort. They must have some sort of an accessory, or maybe they're thinking about coming out with accessories that can thread into that. Why would you want to put a rack on a road bike? This is beats me.
Well, there are those, there's those seat post mounted racks that have tiny stanchions.
Yeah.
That
Hi, how are you?
I need an extra two.
You do, do you?
23x700, is that what the hell it is?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
That'll work.
Yeah. All right, good. And that's what I want.
One?
I already had a flat today.
I hate it when that happens. All right, 48 millimeter valve is cool. It looks like you've been using 60s, but 48 should make it, I would think. You've gone.
Well, actually, this one I think is a 40. What is that? Is that a 60?
That looks like a. They both look like 60s.
Yeah,
to me.
I think the 48 makes, as long as it's.
It's gonna make it.
Yeah, it's gonna make it.
All right, I just want to double check. We've been having, Kenda in general has been having some problems with the tubes. You saw the 60.
Yeah, no, that'll be fine. I mean,
that's fine. Just to be on the lookout, okay? When you're getting tubes now, for at least the next 6 months, be careful of your valve. Open it up, check it out, right around that whole vulcanization.
Oh, because there's little rips or something?
We've been dealing with some trouble. We're streaming live right now. I was telling all of our people, but just to, you know, educate you while you're at it. You see where she's...
Oh, right.
It's a defective tooth. And we've had about six of them. You can see how it's starting there and that, you know what I mean? So that's why we're double checking.
All right, appreciate that.
That's all you need, my friend?
That's it.
$9. Nice day, huh?
Yeah. A little bit nicer by the water.
Nicer in the water.
And nicer in the water.
Yeah.
And nicer yet in the water.
What's that? Oh, you didn't know? Yeah, cute little baby. Cute little baby she had. $9. Excuse me, $11. Enjoy the day.
You too.
So that is the question, Mikito. What are those little screw holes for?
Oh, you know what? Actually, can I borrow that for $110?
Sure. You got it. Yeah, they never are in the back, are they? All right. You guys.
Nope, they're all one size. They're all one size women, one size men.
We got a buddy for him. You have a little club of them, a little tribe. I don't know. They're both pretty bad. I didn't want to look at that last one. Not this last guy. The Mark. Mark was his name. He gives guys with Mark a bad name. I went to get the pincher tools to massage that thing out, and it popped out all by itself. I wanna be a lifeguard. All right, let's see what happens with that.
Good morning.
Hey, how you doing?
Real well, and yourself?
Good. Picking up a bike that I repaired tires.
Cool. When was it brought in?
Last week, actually.
Okay.
You sell helmets too?
Yep.
Inside?
Yep. The last name on
Hoffman.
Color?
Red.
They're going to come back later and try. They're looking to get a couple for the house.
All right, so we put a new tube in there. Golden. You got it. Come on, man. Allie, this young man here is building on a tube, $30 installed, and he's looking for a helmet. Okay? You're welcome, Alon. I got your ticket here, okay, Al? Started there, tube installed, $30. Da, 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 da. All right. Where were they coming out of? Oh, all right. So neat stir. I did. Hello from Texas. How are you, Jim? What's going on? Doreen, Mike, Diamond Mike, Oswego. I love Oswego. I like just to say the name, Oswego. All right. Did go yachting last night. We had fun yachting last night. Hungry! Welcome, Hungry.
Yes, I am. Wow.
And a couple of beers for me. Thank you, Renta. We can use a couple of those. Actually, I'm feeling a little of the effects of a couple too many of them last night with my buddy. Yeah, it was fun. It's all good. It's all good. Every once in a while, you get a little bad. You know what I mean? What do I want to do? Today is pizza day. All right. I've told all the viewers, I'm telling you now, Tony Joke, 700 by 40, 48 millimeter valve, 700 tubes, okay? 700 by 20 to 25 C. Yeah. 48 millimeter valve. We got to physically check each one before they go out the door if you're selling them. That's one of your most popular road bike tubes, okay? 700 by 20 to 25C, 48 millimeter valve. You got to open them up and check at the valve, every single one of them.
And what am I looking for on that valve?
Yeah, here's what you're looking for. You're looking for a slitted. Here's one that came out of the box that we found that was defective before it actually got in. You see that? See how that's a little, yeah. That's what you're gonna be looking for. Anything that looks like that, anything around, you know, and usually if you take your, yeah, that's from that, yeah, look at me. See this one here? And when you push it apart, you see how you pull it apart like that? You see what happened? You can tell it that. And that's what goes, that's where she's letting loose. And it's split. We'll be making a video on that
later.
Enjoy the day, huh? Ride safe now that you got your helmet on. Helmet looks good. All right, so that covers that. Next.
You guys want to do regular pizza, or you want something different on the pizza?
I like regular pizza. So did anybody figure out what those things are for on there? Another thing I don't like about this bicycle, well, I shouldn't necessarily, I don't like about it, but why did the person go with this platform pedal? I don't understand that.
Hi.
Hi, guys.
How are you?
Doing well, and you? Step right up to my office here with that beautiful.
This is Mother's Day, and I haven't been Mother's Day present. I haven't been able to move it yet because we are not skilled enough to get the brakes to work and
okay.
make sure it's all put together safely.
Okay.
So it doesn't need too much, but it needs a little adjusting.
Yeah. Internet or where did it?
Where did they get it? They
yeah.
got it on the internet.
Okay. And then they put it together?
My husband did. Yeah.
Your husband.
Most of it came, and all we only had to put on was the. This thing. Sorry,
no problem.
This thing here.
The rack. Well, you are correct. You know, your brakes are kind of rubbing. And the front one ain't working at all. And the rear one is rubbing. Yeah, sure is. And we're not getting all our gears either. All right, so we got kind of brakes and gears is kind of what we're looking at here, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I think the best thing to do is going to be what we call a mini tune, and we're going to cover everything. We're going to, you know, go over the whole shoot and match from stem to stern. You're looking at $70. You're going to leave it with me. Call me before you come down. All right. All right. We're going to try even harder for that because we don't want to store it either. What's your first name, my dear? Maze? Okay, Maze, hold on. Maeve. I gotcha. Hang on 1 second. Can you name the phone number right on top of that for me right there? That's what they call it.
Pretty good.
Oh.
Pretty good bicycle.
Not a bad little bike.
Not a bad little bike.
Now that it's going to get assembled, right?
For, for an old lady.
Who's that?
And what's your name?
My name is Mark.
Mark. So I ask for you or
no.
whoever answers the phone?
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome, my dear. Have fun. Yep.
I need to buy a lock.
All right. Flat tire's done. Light. But who can ride this bicycle in regular shoes? The integrated computer I kind of like though on that. But the only thing is when it screws up, then what do you do?
Ooh.
All right, I got one. We're only broadcasting for 4 hours today. We're not going to go all the way. We're not doing two broadcasts today. Last weekend we did two broadcasts. This weekend we're only doing one. My iPhone alert. What the heck is that? didn't quite get that dude. I didn't understand that. Oh, now I know who it is. Oh, I'll text him back. We never blocked you, man. Something, we didn't have anything to do with it. We don't block unless it's really absurd and nasty. So, hey, you lost a supporter. If you gotta go, you gotta go. But just so you know, we did not block you. Getting ready. Just cleaning up this bag of list. I get rambling on and it's screwed up. I'm gonna lock this when it starts over. It's gonna be a problem. I don't know. Blocked. Somebody got blocked or something because they said something about the economy way back when.
That guy blocked probably searching for that's true.
What's that?
The guy that got blocked should probably start changing.
Yeah. We never blocked you. If you're not going to be a supporter anymore, I understand. But we had nothing to do with blocking you.
All right.
Next. With that fancy carbon bike. And with all kinds of fancy carbon bikes nowadays, they're starting to get more and more particular. And they want to have us using a torque wrench. So we decided to purchase a torque wrench from Torque Control. It's a torque tool. Torque limiting cam over clutch prevents over tightening of critical fasteners. It's a 1/4-inch hex magnet bit shank with 6 bits. Ergo lever. It's anywhere from 2 to 8 Newton meters. Newton meters, Newton pounds, Newton whatever. Just turn the knob to the desired torque setting between 2.0 and 8. It is a division of Snap-on, CDI Torque Products. www.snaponindustrybrands.com. Now, they have a little calibration here on here, and they're giving you the test points and whatnot, and how it was. At 2, it's reading right on the money, pretty much. At 5 Newton, we're a little bit high, and at 8, it's a little bit higher. So you might want to dial it down just a little bit lower. Let me show you how it works. Coming in tight, son of a? I'm going to bring it out in the sun, huh? The Torx tool, again, the bits, the different bits that we have that are going to go into here. Very simple and easy. Pull it out of the thing. You know, you guys are familiar with that. Okay. And then, whenever what you want to, this is the part that turns, and it's going to, this is going to go up or down, and then you have the degrees of points up or down. So when you're all the way down here to the end, there's 2. So you want 2.1, there's 2.2, and then 0.1, 2.2, 2.3, obviously, blah, 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 blah. Okay? And keep going and going and going up into the, you know, and as it goes up and whatnot. And then this is going to go in there, and you're going to turn it on for you. You're with me. Now, a lot of your stuff is, oh, the other thing that this one comes with is 2 longer bits as well to be able to go into. I don't know. This is Torx for like this rake and that kind of stuff. All right, so it's gonna goes into. Get to the right side. Good. So, are you with me? So right now we're on 4, and when you turn it, you see how that just moves like that? That's how it, you know, if you got it up to, when it gets to that certain tightness. So that was way too good. So again. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
It's a big day for me.
It's a big day for you?
Yeah.
Oh yeah? How big?
I want to tell you about this bike.
Yeah, I bet you do. And I want to hear it. This is a classic.
5,000 miles on it.
That's it?
Yeah. Well, I haven't ridden it in 45 years.
Our viewers are loving this right now. Let's get this into there. This is a classic old Impala right now. Wow. You haven't run it in how long?
45 years.
No. You had kids on here, though.
Oh, that's true. For a brief period, when my eldest was born.
And how old is he now?
He's 22.
Yeah.
Through the Canadian Rockies, Calgary, Banff, Jasper.
All of them.
And I've bought much more expensive bikes since, and none of them have ever been
treated
right.
You like this. Old Campy Grupo on there, Carter crank. I mean, you what year did you buy this thing? This has got to be 70s.
15, so that was 40 years ago. So I was 70.
Sounds about right.
Oh, I had it in college too.
I was going to say Ann Arbor.
Yep. Got to register your bike.
Old kryptonite lock. No more.
So I miscalculated. When was the last time I rode it? Let's see.
I got you thinking on that one now, didn't I?
22 years ago. 20 years ago, I was riding it with Max on the back. So that was brief. And in Ann Arbor briefly. So I haven't ridden it really, you know, really ridden it since for 40 years, say, with brief intervals in between. What do you need for a basket? What do you think?
All the parts are working. Like that.
Yeah.
I want to get new ink tape. If you could do that for me, I'd really appreciate it.
Do whatever you want. You know, we'll you know, tell me what you want to do, and that's what we'll do.
Lose this thing.
Okay.
This needs to be treated, but I'm not sure. I don't want to. It's too dry. What do? You turn it upside down, let it soak like that?
I would put, you know, like a linseed oil or something like that.
Yeah, underneath, right?
No. It's just going to, you know, on top is going to do nothing but just, you know, exactly. You know, just soften it up a little, supple it, yeah. They make specific stuff, but, you know, neat's foot oil, something like that, you know?
So I guess, broadly speaking, it's a tune-up and a clean-up. Even the chain is really not rusty.
Again, it comes down to, you know, what's the ultimate goal with the bicycle? What are you going to do with it? Are you going to just ride it? Are you going to ride it, serious ride it again? Or are you going, you know, basically back and forth to town and I'll go out for maybe an hour or something like that, that kind of thing?
Yeah, exactly. Maybe 2 hours.
Okay. You want to clean it up? You want to get the gook off of it?
Yeah, I mean, because right now the brakes are working actually pretty well. That's fine, actually, but with use, the gook will, see, it just got stuck on the left.
What's that?
It got stuck because of all the gook.
Well.
They're rust.
I don't know. Let's see what that is.
What can I do about that?
What can I do about that?
You know, again, whatever you want. Let's pull this up here.
The viewers are loving this.
They are loving it.
Got a reality TV show going on.
Yeah, sure do. What do you have going on? Potential for 40,000 views. We're streaming live right this second to around the world.
Wait, are we on
seriously?
Right this second, you are streaming live around the world with a potential of 40,000 views. When you came by, you saw the YouTube, you know, live filming area right there. If you want to see that, and here you are, right there. And there's how many people you got watching you right now. And they're probably commenting about that bike. Now, don't get too nasty, all right? Here's what you got looking. The main thing on that bike probably needs for all the gear cables replaced, along with the freewheel and the chain. Stuck seat posts. You know, these guys are all, I told you, they're loving this bike right now, all right? Atala is not that I know of. I'm not positive on that though. I mean, they could have got bought out, and maybe not in the United States anyway. What's your first name?
Richard.
All right, Richard. So I'm looking at, you know, it definitely needs two new tires and two new tubes. So right there is 100 bucks. Cables, do they need to be replaced? Well, that front one sure probably does. And that brake, okay? The rear one, probably not a bad idea, but when it's sticking like that, you know, I got the casing issues going on here. We probably should be replacing that, you know, this is not healthy.
Yeah.
And that's partly the reason why it's, you know, again. If you wanted to have white, we can do white, I guess. We can order it up, but, you know, black is kind of the preferred color of casing nowadays. Again, to what degree of restoration do you want to go? We can go as far as you want.
So
You want to be able to clean it all up and get all the gook and all the grime and all the crap that's embedded in that chain all out of there. We can do whatever you want to do.
All right, well, I'm not an extremist, but suppose we considered it a restoration project. We'd get white cables, we'd clean the gook, we'd replace the cables and get white ones.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously the tires and tubes, not a whole lot else to it, right? What am I looking at if we do it that way rather than just the bare minimum?
I told you they were going to love this bike. they want you to go to full Monty. Yeah, okay.
What are we talking about?
By the time we're all said and done, we're probably looking at, like, with the tape and whatnot, I'm going to price it out, like we talked about. But we're probably going to be coming closer around $250 to $300 by the time we're all said and done.
It's twice what I paid for it.
I hear you.
That doesn't mean anything.
Yeah, I hear you.
But I
mean, are we in the budget part? Okay. You're up for that. Yep. Okay. Yep. So I'm looking for authorization of up to $300. We're going to remove this.
Yeah. And this.
Okay.
This. Do they still make pumps that will fit this?
No.
Remove that. Yeah. I do need to have a. That was for a water bottle.
No, this was for a lock. This is for a water bottle.
Oh, right.
Remove the old, this guy as well?
Well.
It works. That works. And that'll fit just about any bottle. It'll clean up. It's not going to come out perfect. Okay, Richard, some of this stuff is not, but a lot of the details of this bicycle are going to clean up really nice. But it's not going to come, again, we're not totally stripping it all down, repainting, doing that. Yeah. It's going to clean up.
Yeah. What about your stickers?
What about your Chiquita banana stickers? Yeah, some of this stuff is, you might lose a couple of stickers in the wash process, okay? Don't get upset with me, all right? But we're going to make it look and run as best we possibly can with what we got to work with. So all brackets are off except.
That's right. This was one of those U
big fat nut. Yeah, one of the original kryptonite locks that were. Exactly. It was kryptonite. Flat. It was a flat metal.
Yeah.
And you squished it together. You put it into there, and then you let it spring apart, and that's what held on.
I got that when I brought it to college.
I've been doing it as long as you've had this bicycle.
That was a
baby seat that went onto that.
Do you remember that? And I had to relearn how to get on the bike, like kicking over the handlebars. It's like when we had saddlebags back there.
All right, now we got to come out. Are we doing red, black,
and yellow?
Let's go inside and take a look.
What are
the choices? Right? I don't know if I got yellow. You could do Rasta. You want to do the vintage stuff? We got cotton.
Yeah.
We got cotton in white, blue, and red, or then you're going into pork, which is that's the stuff of choice nowadays. No, I got that in all these different colors. Boom, 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 boom. No straight yellow. Absolutely.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
You're welcome. Have a wonderful day.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
with the red.
You got it. They're loving it. All right, Richard, give me name and address. A name and phone number on there for me, please.
No.
Leave them on. This hunk of chain here, is this sentimental or what's up with that?
No.
Junk?
Junk.
And we're gonna do the white casing, right?
How long will that take?
The whole bike is probably gonna take me about a week.
With the ordering the casing?
Yeah, definitely. Pump bracket's going, right?
Yeah, one of your viewers suggested we get the old pump on eBay, but newer pumps are better anyway.
The other thing too is, are you really gonna change a flat out in the middle of the?
Probably not.
Okay, so you know what? You don't need a pump.
Yeah.
You know, those days are over. You know what I mean?
Carry around a spare tire.
I'm with you. I mean, if you did those kind of touring, you definitely.
I remember when I bought this one, it was really great, so much better than the previous one.
I wouldn't have thrown it in there if I know you were going to keep them. I'm sorry. What's that?
No, it's okay. It hadn't occurred to me to keep it.
I kept asking, is it going? Is it going? I figured, it's going, it's going. Yeah. All right, and this is going off of there too?
Yeah.
You got it. And then we'll get some oil on that seat. We're gonna get that going ASAP before it gets to the prep station.
Great.
No, the seat's staying, but it's just got to get a little rejuvenation.
All right.
Thank
you very much.
You're welcome. Very much. You got your phone number on there. Everything's good.
Yep, we got everything.
Yeah, that's
good. You got it.
Okay. And your first name?
I'm Bart. Okay. You don't want that, right?
No.
No, they know. If he's 23 now.
Amazing that happens, huh?
Okay.
Thank you.
See ya. Classic. This bolt sucks. I'm putting a new bolt on there. Maybe he wants to save the bolt. I need a new seat post bolt. One of them nice ones, where'd they go? The whole bolt. Got no bolts. Thank you.
Mm.
That is a classic, folks. I don't know if I would have done what he's doing to it, to tell you the truth. I don't know if I would have went that route. He's more sentimental than anything else. All right, we gotta hit that warehouse. When we go to get the pizza. Oh, somebody already went to get the pizza? Oh, I guess so, my truck ain't there. You're gonna need, what do you need? Do you need, we need a tire? We need one of them street, some of them street tires over here. You better get a couple of those. Yeah, we'll update it. Hola. No, it is not a 700C. It's a 27 one and a quarter. Inflate to 55. Yeah. Mm. And then you know we got this business going on here with this with his brake hoods. What are we gonna do about that? Well, it's you know they're dry rotted from 18 million years ago. We wrapped them up with tape. Look at that. Thick and zesty. You're going with red. What else do we got? More helicopters. Get them helicopters done. That way we're done with them helicopters. We don't have to worry about it. What a mess. I'm gonna need a seat post bolt. I'm gonna put seat post bolts on the thing. This is going to be the nightmare bike for the week. I can smell it. Seat post bolt we need. We need white casing. I haven't ordered white casing in I don't know how long. We don't have any white casing in house, right? Thank you. Yeah. It's a...
Deli?
Pizza! So... What are you looking for? What'd you say?
I was gonna ask if you want something from yeah.
No. Oh, so we were back on that. We were talking about this torque. So anyway, there's that torque, and then you can go all the way up to 8 newton. And there's, again, it turns to whatever. So it's going to give you the right amount of tension to go in to these fancy bicycles, so that you don't crack the carbon or this or that. So there you have it on torque control. There'll be a formal video coming up pretty soon on this whole shooting match, I'm sure. But for now, we own one in case we get some serious stuff going on. And we should probably start to use it, especially like around seat posts and racks and that kind of stuff. So we're going to keep that over here for now.
Your YouTube sensation now? Is that what we're doing?
Is that what it is? Mandy, how are you?
I'm great, sweetie. How are you?
Oh, stupendous.
So what are you doing on YouTube? What's this whole story?
We're streaming live right this very second.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
People checking you out?
Mm-hmm.
All right. That's fun.
The potential for 40,000 views. We got people all over the world watching us, watching your every move right this second. So say hello to everybody out there in YouTube land.
No problem. You know the other thing I wanted to ask you about when I pick up my bike? Do you have any of those like folding chairs that have like the backpack straps on them? Does that make any sense?
Inside item.
Should I just go look?
Yeah, they got beach chairs. I don't know if they got a strap on them. Yeah, you like load it on like a backpack. I've seen what you're talking about. Talk to them inside while I get your bike. So he originally had to have red tape on here. Oh, yeah. He's a red kind of guy. You get this ready for Sebastian over there. Yeah. Would anybody like some nice vintage tape? Yuck. Yeah, I don't know if I would have done this. This is a terrible, this is gonna be a big one.
the other half? Oh, she looks beautiful.
Oh, yes.
Oh, she looks beautiful. Now we can start the commute. Oh, I wonder if I remember that. Hold me to that. Yeah, sometimes, right? That's my birthday.
Try that.
Oh, great. Now everybody on YouTube knows the locks of my
There you go. They're going to gonna hunt you down.
Yeah, exactly. They're going to come across the pond.
You're gonna find
and
me.
Steal
my bicycle.
All righty.
Sure, thank you. I know, they changed everything.
It looks great.
It does look nice, yeah. I was concerned, but it came out good.
All right, now, where am I?
It's a nice old bike.
I don't know if we were just debating on it.
Everybody, you don't think you can bring it back?
I know I can bring it back. To what degree do they want to bring it back to? You know, that's the whole, that's what it comes down.
How much restoration?
Yeah, you know, we budgeted $300 here, so.
What year you figure is made?
This one?
Yeah.
Yeah, we were just talking about it when he brought it in. 70s, early 70s is what it is. It's a cool classic old bike, and, you know, but.
What's it worth?
Yeah.
Right.
You know, it's sentimental, you know, it's what it boils down.
Now, Mandy, are you working in Brooklyn, or are you...
Well, I'm actually working in downtown Manhattan.
Okay, so right
across. I live in Brooklyn.
Right, right. And you got, you got a place a few years ago. Whereabouts are you?
I live in Bay Ridge.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, it's nice down there.
Sweet.
It's one of those things, like, you get a lot of neighborhood for your money.
Yep.
So I could afford it. The only drawback to a place like Bay Ridge is it's far away. I mean, I'm on the train for a while, and I work downtown. I mean,
okay.
I work in the Lower East Side.
What's your commute time?
An hour.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, you're way down in Brooklyn. I mean, it's out there.
Wow.
Yeah. But it's worth it, I mean, because I wanted to buy.
Exactly.
And I could buy a beverage, and the neighborhood is gorgeous. So, I mean, I could afford it.
Exactly.
You get a ton of neighborhood, but that's the catch. The catch is that my commute is long. So now I've been walking, and got obsessed with the podcast. I got my summer job. I'm writing curriculum more downtown, right by the Brooklyn Bridge.
Cool.
And I got obsessed with the podcast last week. So I started, I think for the last 3 days, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, I've been walking from the Brooklyn Bridge, like 9 miles. So, and if I can do it walking, I can certainly do it on my bike.
Yeah. You have a helmet? You have a helmet, right?
Yeah. Like, we don't do helmets on the beach cruising, but I definitely.
If you're not in a rush, cruise home, you de-stress by the time you get home. And
perfect. Nice sunshine. I mean, why not be outside? Why get on the train? Plus the fact that if I can do, I'm only doing 4 days a week out there, and then I'm here for the weekends.
Beautiful.
If I can get away with July and August, not buying a monthly Metro card, just getting a couple of swipes, using it here and there, like if I'm not using it during the day.
Exactly.
If I don't buy one Metro card,
an extra scarf.
If I don't buy one Metro card, it pays for the repairs of my
scarf.
Yeah.
Getting ahead in the summer while it's nice. Exactly.
Always,
darling.
Always a pleasure. Thank you so much.
You're welcome,
my dear.
Enjoy the rest of your day.
You do the same.
Good luck on your YouTube stardom.
No, thank you.
Yeah, tell Fred I got to
Oh, isn't it the greatest? I'm like a season behind because I don't have cable in my house.
We have a rainy day. It's on demand. Go watch it.
Oh, my guy's the best. He's a lead driver, man.
Love it.
Woohoo! I'll see you guys later.
Alright. What's that?
7-11.
Oh, yeah. Oh, because it's free Slurpee Day. It is free Slurpee Day. Thank you. I didn't say I wasn't going to sell them. No, I never said that. I never said I wasn't going to sell them anymore. No way. Now you're putting words in my mouth.
Well, I said I guess I'll get it because he's not selling them anymore.
Oh, all right. How many do you need? That is only $629. $13, actually. Well, the stuff that's in between, it's two in between, you know? It's either all or nothing, you know? So how may we help you out today, Jim?
Need some chain oil.
You need some lube? Yeah, you can go right inside and see Tony Joe or Allie. See, they're in there. White Lightning is the stuff. Eka. Well, this is classic for you guys. I'm sure you're enjoying it. What's going on, gentlemen?
Hello. How are you?
It's stupendous. And you guys?
Fantastic.
Got the wheel with you? There's a couple of different flavors and concerns. That when you say the nut, I mean, is it a quick release style? Is, you know, does it have a lever on it that looks like that, or it's a real, it's just a, it is a bolt, a nut. It is a nut. Yeah, I'm going to need to see it. Yeah, bring me everything you got, and then we'll match it up accordingly.
Thank you.
Yep.
Greetings, Bert.
How are you?
How are you?
I'm doing great. Yeah.
How may I help you?
Hi there.
Go for it, Richard. I don't know if they make it in that cotton style. Okay. Okay. In a hot yellow. Okay. I'll see what I can find. You will.
Bye.
Yellow. Maybe we should stop everything. Maybe they change his mind. I'll be right with you there, Tony.
Yeah, I know. Thank you, Bart.
Allie, can you help me out with my buddy Jim here, please?
Hang tight here. Bart, be right with you. Thank you. Let me help you. Excuse me.
Bless you.
Thank you.
Good repair. What if the spokes broke off?
Chain stuck in it.
Stuck in
it. Oh, sure.
All right.
Bart's going to
that bike's
to
been
tell you exactly what
put through the mill a little bit, huh?
Your
name? Jill.
And you? So talk to me, my dear.
I'm with you. I'm left. Yeah, you can go on. What's the best number for you?
I bet it is.
Bart's helping out these guys.
The surgeon.
The bike surgeon. Thank you. You're welcome. Quote you whatever.
All right. We're beating on it pretty good, but it's, you know, it's surging pretty well, huh?
Yep.
The salt water is raising havoc with this thing. You're going through puddles and whatnot, and that's partly what we're dealing with. I don't necessarily think we need to put a brand new chain on there yet, because again, it's probably just going to keep on getting beat up the way it is. I'd be looking for authorization. Brakes and gears is kind of what I'm hearing. You know, is with the giant chain and all of the above. If he wants them to work, I'm pretty sure that I'm going to have to replace these cages. Now, if we leave it in one gear, that would be one thing that we can do as well. I don't, you know. what's fine? Leaving it in one gear. Okay? Because that's probably what you've been move up. So how much is he going to get? Where are we at? Yep. That are going on. Here we go. 35. Yeah. So. Yeah. So that's it. You got